Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1653. Map your Excel data with GeoFlow. Well, here's another cool feature. This is a product called GeoFlow that's from Microsoft. It's going to be an add-in for Excel 2013 Pro Plus. It's only in an early beta right now. It'll probably be released later in 2013, maybe early 2014. And so I have 5,000 rows of data here. There is an address component, address, city, state, zip. It works with latitude, longitude, works with just city, state, country. Also have some information here to classify. These are libraries. We mailed Don't Fear the Spreadsheet to a whole bunch of libraries. Mailed it to the main branch and then it feared it would flow out to be available at the branch library. So I have some dates. The data was mailed. The data I figured that it's going to hit based on how far away it is. And I want to take a look at this data on a map. Now, traditionally we'd use Microsoft MapPoint for this, but GeoFlow is a great new product that allows us to build a tour. So today I'm going to show you the tour. Tomorrow we'll take a look at what actually happens. This is, you know, essentially it's like a pivot table field list on a map. We get to specify which fields represent the height, which fields are the geographic fields, and we also get to show a time component. So, you know, I'm here in Ohio, and this is showing how the books stretched out across the country based on, you know, the typical delays for the U.S. Postal Service, and then the other colors, the blue, are the branch libraries that eventually will be added to the catalog. Okay, now, because of the beta here, at each scene, the colors change, so that's why the colors changed. I saw a later version at the MVP Summit last week, and, you know, those things are improved, as well as additional themes, and all kinds of improvements. But even with this early beta, this is very cool. You can use the Control and Alt keys and your mouse and the wheel mouse to zoom in. But this is all built into the tour. So initially here I zoomed in on Florida so we could take a look at how, like, look in Southeast Florida, there's three tall spikes. So that's Miami-Dade County, Fort Lauderdale, and then West Palm Beach. Three books that were sent are basically going to cover all of the branches that cover that entire southeast coast of Florida. And then, you know, we also have Naples, Tampa, St. Pete, Orlando, my second home library of Brevard County, and Jacksonville. And we can fly up. So, you know, in Florida, we had to send a lot of books and covered a lot of the area here in Birmingham and Alabama. Those were the only two library systems that were quote-unquote large enough, you know, for our budget. We had a certain budget of books that we could send out. And so in the tour, I built in these delays, 10, 15 second delays, that allow me just to talk about it. Now, I didn't know exactly what I was going to say, but I built in enough time that I could kind of cover it. And here we go up to the Northeast and so on. Okay, so now I'm going to stop the tour at this point. I'm going to pause just to show you the kinds of things we can do. So I'm going to take the mouse, I'm going to click and drag, and that allows me to recenter the map. I can zoom in or zoom out. So I'm going to hold down the Control key and wheel mouse up to zoom in, or wheel mouse out to zoom out. Pretty responsive, right? I'm going to hold down the Alt key and kind of go in a dragging circular motion that allows me to tip and rotate the map. And then with the Alt key, I'm going to drag up to tip the map away from me. That allows me to see the height of the bars better, or drag down to tip the map into more of a you know, higher view. And so this is a really, really cool product from Microsoft called GeoFlow. You have to have Excel 2013 Pro Plus because it's using data in the Power Pivot engine. Here, let's go back and just take a quick look at the Power Pivot window. Now, again, this is a very early beta. You see we have a field list over here where we can specify the height of the columns, the category that changes the color, and then also a time component. I can drag one of those date fields down there and watch it animate out over time. Really, really interesting product. Go ahead out to Bing or Google and search for GeoFlow, and you might see when the public beta will become available. Okay, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast. Mr. Excel.